imagine you are working with lots of data in your database, hundreds of tables, several columns, and you're being asked the question, what was the impact of the customer satisfaction on sales last month? It's a complex question that even though you have access to the data, it's very difficult to pull out the right data that scope down to this one question and be able to answer the question every single time reliably. So in this video, I will walk you through a structured approach where we're going to combine the semantic layer with a large language model so you can answer this kind of question consistently and reliably. Starting with the data source that you have. Let's say it's a database or a data warehouse. And here we have our user who is asking these questions. And over there, we'll put the answer. But before we talk about the approach, let's first set some goals for the approach. So we'll have three goals. We have the approach to be scalable. We also want it to have accurate and consistent. And consistent here means everybody asking the same question or a similar question, they need to get the same answer. A very simple approach would be to pull everything from the database and answer the question. And we'll describe that by, we'll have the tables and columns and select, we'll select some of these tables to answer the question. And then we'll pass it to a query layer that will pull the data based on the select set of tables. Once we have the data pulled out from the database, we'll pass it to a summarize task, which will use a large language model to answer the question. And then based on that, we'll have the answer. That approach works nicely if you have a very generic and a small set of data. It will break if the data is a lot more than a few thousand of rows because you're gonna go beyond the token limit for the large language model. And also in the same time, even if the data is small, the model doesn't understand the business definitions, the vocabulary, or any of the calculations you have specific to your business. So let's first solve the scalability issue, which is our first goal. We'll introduce SQL step in the middle. In this step, instead of loading everything from the database, we will rely on the large language model using the set of tables to generate SQL. So this task will call the LLM using the set of tables, get back a refined SQL that will scope down just right to what we need to answer the question. Then pass that to the query, summarize it, and get the answer. So that's great. It will scale up to any amount of data you have, but we didn't solve the other goals yet. Now let's focus on the accuracy and the consistency. For those, we'll introduce the semantic layer. Think of the semantic layer as an artifact you create to describe your tables and columns using the business definitions and vocabulary. It will also include any calculations, like how do you calculate the cost of goods, or how do you calculate the sales over whatever amount of period of time. Using that, you will be able to teach the model how to answer questions in a way that's relevant to your business. But that's not enough. Semantic layers don't really capture KPIs, like how do you track the revenue versus its target or the projected values for revenues? Or when you track sales, do you calculate sales over a month, a quarter, or a year? So that's where we introduce the metric definition. Alongside with the benefit I just mentioned about metric definition, it will also scope down the amount of columns and tables we are talking about, because the metric definition will only include those that are relevant to the KPI that you are interested in. So by using the semantic layer and the metric definition, we can pass specifically what's required to answer the question to the large language model, get the relevant query that now is a lot more relevant to our question and our business, and get the answer. In the same time, metric definitions, when they are published to a centralized metric definition catalog, that catalog will make them available to all of your users in the business, and hence it will address the consistency. So now we have addressed the scalability, the accuracy, and the consistency by combining those techniques together.